rift is sealed. We're safe now.
Alas, if only I could be so certain.
Team in the lab just figured out how to upgrade your ISO 8. Better stop in.
Mindless ones. Their only instincts are to defend this dimension and to conquer others.
Hey, I landed the role of mindless one on this team fair and square. No way I'm letting those dudes steal my deal.
Jump in any time now, darlings. These monsters won't hunt themselves. We've got to stop these beasties before they overflow into our reality. That about does it. Tea, anyone? How many lumps, darling? Fun's just getting started. This dimension is teeming with lovely leviathans like that. I'm a monster hunter, dear. So when a rift opens in downtown London and giant stone brutes pour out, it's my job to stop them. Even if it means delivering them back home myself. I've seen a few, yeah. Haven't figured out a way to close them yet, though. Bit of might busy keeping those golems from invading our world and all. You go right ahead, love. I've got my eye on something else. Something shiny.
Magic powering these portals is unusual. Even for the Dark Dimension. I fathom I've already jumped through enough holes in reality for one day, sweetie.
Be on the lookout for anything unusual in that region.
Another rift. It's as if the fabric between dimensional planes is beginning to shred. Can't let the mindless ones cross to the other side. This artifact is releasing powerful arcane energy. Could it have something to do with the rift? The magic from this artifact is somehow powering the rift. Destroying it will close the crack and keep the darkness from seeping into other dimensions.
Ha!
magical signature of each artifact seems to correspond with a similarly colored rift. Rift is different. Stronger. I can feel it. It's beyond the point where smashing some trinkets will seal it.
Is it mortal? It was nothing compared to what I had to do to break out of the afterlife. No, just cursed. There have been plenty of times that death seemed like a welcome change, however. I was dragged there by a powerful demon and things took an ugly turn. When I saw that rift, I wasted no time in making my escape. You have no idea. But should you ever spill innocent blood, I promise you shall find out someday.
portals lead to different dimensions. We have to seal them shut before the realities converge.
Doctor, I'm so glad you're here. Something is wrong. These portals... they're getting bigger? No. That must be a mistake. The spell you're casting... it's expanding the rift. You have to stop!
I cannot cease. Until all realities are one. So I am commanded by the dread Dormammu. Let the dark magic of this dimension consume you! From my own!
Oh no, dear doctor. I have not finished with you yet. I've waited so long to make you mine, Strange. Oh, how the mighty have fallen. Even a sorcerer supreme pales when compared to the dread Dormammu. Your mortal allies will die by your own hands. This is but a small taste of Dormammu's mystic might. Strange tries to kill you. You still fight to save him. Such fascinating creature. Yes, you're Strange. Your soul will be mine. So swears Dormammu.
That was quite an impressive feat. But vanquishing the true Dormammu in his own realm will be nearly impossible. Lucky for us, the impossible is my specialty. Apology for all of that unpleasantness. I will, but first we need to deal with Dormammu. That was no more than a shadow of his true power. He's the master of this dimension and can twist its dark magic to his whims. And it gets worse. Dormammu has an Infinity Stone. It's what opened the first rift between our dimensions. I tried to chase it here, but it was too late. For me, and perhaps for reality as we know it. I'm afraid so. And unless we stop him, he'll make every dimension as dark as this one. We'll need to make our way to Dormammu's lair, and pick up a little something extra along the way. Dormammu's toying with the Reality Stone's power. He's altering the fundamental properties of this dimension, right down to our perception of it. You'll have to watch your step next time. I may not always be here to catch you. Magic born in this dimension. But the Reality Stone has created an anomaly. Dark crystals that we can use to absorb and reflect Dormammu's energy. If we can find them. These are the crystals I spoke of. I can sense that you carry similar ones already. We should be able to use these to erect a mystical shield. Block their attack and absorb the energy. Now, the crystals are more fragile than I expected. But there should be more as we traverse closer to Dormammu and the stone.
Winding paths and war calls are giving me a bloody migraine.
Huh? Sitarak!
Mamu's toying with a reality stone's power. He's altering the fundamental properties of this dimension, right down to our
The Kingpin had no idea the power he possessed. But I've been watching, and I now know what these crystals can do in more experienced hands. Here, let me show you. You heroes have no idea what you found. Do you? I was keeping my eyes on you, but perhaps the time has come for fists instead. You fight with honor. That's your first mistake. Crystals, ISO-8, call them what you will. Soon, they'll all be mine. And you thought one of me was hard to handle. Take your spoils.
I must admit, this alliance you've built is quite inspiring. Perhaps I should craft one of my own.
Well, that was certainly unusual. Anyone know what that was all about?
All that matters is that he is gone. And we have his crystals. And that Dormammu lies ahead.
Dormammu's lair is near. Focus the energy from the crystals to destroy his enchanted barrier. We can't delay. Dormammu's shield must be broken. We can absorb their attacks with the crystals and redirect the energy at the barrier. You'll need more crystals to destroy the barrier. Luckily, the Mindless Ones are bringing them right to us. Breach the barrier! Nowhere left to hide now, Dormammu!
Accustomed to chaos, but this realm makes even my head spin!
You know, I'm suddenly kind of glad I didn't have those tacos after all. Because I'd probably be spewing them back into my mask about now.
Sorcerer is true. truly supreme, Steven.
I have Dormammu, and he is about to extinguish your flame once and for all. Damage. Use the crystals to absorb his beams and create an opening for attack.
Yeah!
stronger than ever before.
What a dreadful debacle this devolved into. Oh, it still stands strong. It has merely been temporarily trumped by the megalithic magician and his flaming facade. Indeed, a fortuitous finding we could never have anticipated upon arriving in this dismal dimension. I am excited to examine it upon returning. Calm your concerns, comrade. This sapphire scientist has friends with formidable facilities all over our world, and on countless others.
You cannot destroy the darkness.
He's right, you know. Dormammu feeds off this dimension's endless arcane energies. He can't die in this place. But we most definitely can. And if Dormammu spills this black magic into our world, he would be unstoppable there too. Of course, without the Reality Stone, he can't merge our dimensions together. And without the darkness to fuel him, he wouldn't last long. So, if I can open a portal back to our plane of existence, perhaps we can take the stone somewhere safe. Or at least, somewhere safer than this.
We came here to escape the chaos of Earth. Our people were trapped at the heart of far too many conflicts over the centuries. Assailed from all sides by those who wish to harm or exploit us. Only by removing ourselves from their world could we ever truly hope to find peace. So, tell us, my dear sister. Why have you opened our doors to the same chaos we fought so hard to leave behind?
No matter how we may try to cut ourselves off from our home planet, my queen, we still have friends and allies who need our help. Who are we to ignore their plight?
We are Inhumans. As both humans and mutants alike have repeatedly reminded us, we stand alone. And unless your friends can convince the king otherwise, so do they. For the sake of my sister, I will hear what you have come to say. But I guarantee no more. Now speak. We know of these stones. And the fact that you would bring them here puts all of Attilan in jeopardy. Such recklessness is typical of your kind. That time has long since passed. We have been hunted by humans for centuries. The scars from our war with the mutants are still fresh. The only allies we have left dwell within this city. The Inhumans hide from no one. Our removal from Earth was a strategic maneuver for the protection of our people. I cannot. Attilan may be among the stars now, but Earth will always be our home. I believe my king would agree. Our cousin Gorgon will escort you to the lab.
Attilan gone mad?
Gorgon has been gravely wounded. You must attend to him immediately.
I'll see what I can do, Your Majesty. There you go, big guy. This should stop the bleeding. Before you know it, you'll be back on your feet. Or hooves.
Some sort of amber. Intriguing. I don't believe we've had the pleasure, young man. Huh? Oh.
Few have. Thane came to us from the inhuman colony of Orlan, seeking sanctuary.
Sanctuary? From what, pray tell?
Not what. But rather, who?
My father. Turns out he's a maniacal alien warlord bent on universal domination. And for some reason, he really wants me dead. His name is Thanos. If you're lucky, you've never heard of him.
Luck hasn't exactly been on our side today, my boy. But I have a feeling that may be about to change.
How can I help you? So I'm told. I've never actually met him, and I can't say I'm too upset about that fact. Seeing that he tried to have me killed as soon as he found out about me. A bit of both. My mother was an inhuman from the lost city of Orlan. After the Black Order decimated our colony to get to me, I had no choice but to flee here. Only legends, and none of them end well. If my father wants them so badly, though, I've got to believe some of them are true. Let's hope so. Until then, I have a patient to tend to. Somewhere safe. I'll try to rest and...
No. Nowhere in Attilan is safe. I remember now. He's lost his twisted mind. Again.
Oh, come now, cousin. Is that any way to talk about the new king of the Inhumans?
Gorgon from further damage. You focus on the Alpha Primitives.
I should have known you were behind this, Maximus. Only you would dare betray our people.
I am nothing if not predictable. Isn't that right, brother? A silent treatment, as always. But I'll give you something to talk about. Just you wait.
Crimson Banners of Sephiroth!
I am gone!
Imagination. It is time that someone with true vision took the throne.
The Inhumans are the closest thing to a family I have now.
I'm not a fighter, but I guess this is my battle.
This isn't the first time Maximus has tried to claim the throne from his brother. Not even close. The guy's a brilliant inventor, but he's never been quite right in the head. Still, matter not, he is faithful. We refuse to give up on him, even if he refuses to change his ways.
Interesting change of pace. Your pathetic attempts to resist are almost adorable. Is about to expire.
Over here. I can generate enough amber to protect you. Stay close to me.
Flames of the foe.
What can I do for you? Maybe. But if the Black Order is out there searching for it, having me on your side might put you in even more danger. I can't take that chance. Well, when you put it that way... Right. No pressure.
This is Winter Soldier, broadcasting on the Avengers emergency frequency. Again. This is Winter Soldier, broadcasting on the Avengers emergency frequency. Again. If anyone is listening out there, my mission to infiltrate AIM was a success. At least until MODOK and his nerd squad somehow recovered a bona fide Infinity Stone. Wasn't about to wait around and find out what they plan to do with it. So I blew my cover and grabbed their rock. I'm approaching a secure location with a stone in hand, but it won't take long for those eggheads to figure out where I'm headed and try to take it back. So, if you can hear this, Avengers, lock on to these coordinates and swing on by. It'd be a shame to be stuck in paradise all alone.
These are the coordinates.